Good morning and welcome to St. Columba's and our service today. You'll find the service printed in your bulletin. Our online friends can find the bulletin at our website, stcolumbaca.com. Couple of reminders, our Thursday morning Eucharists have resumed, Thursdays at 10 o'clock. So if you'd like to be a part of that worshiping community, you're welcome to join us then as well. A celebration of the life of Martha Lamar will be held here in the church next Saturday at 1 o'clock with a reception following. So please continue to keep Martha and her family in your prayers. There are two upcoming summer book discussions that we are having in conjunction with Mount Cross, and they are both listed on the back page of your bulletin with details. So if you'd like to be a part of one or both, you are very welcome to do so for your summer reading enjoyment. Following the service, we will have a time for coffee and conversation, so we hope that you'll join us in the parish hall after the service. Our reader today is Maurice Hill. Our intercessor is Maria Fernandez. Our music today is by Brett Hanley and all of you. And our tech crew is Tim Helton, Nancy Miller, Richard Stone, and Cliff Agin. So let us stand as you are able and sing together our opening hymn, "Lift Up Your Heads, Ye Mighty Gates."
The Lord be with you.
Let us pray. O Lord, mercifully receive the prayers of your people who call upon you, and grant that they may know and understand what things they ought to do, and also may have grace and power faithfully to accomplish them. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
Our first reading is from the second book of Samuel. King David leads 30,000 Israelites in a joyous procession with the Ark of God, and then shares food with all the people. Listen now for the word of God. David again gathered all the chosen men of Israel, 30,000. David and all the people with him set out and went from Beljudah to bring up from there the Ark of God, which is called by the name of the Lord of hosts, who is enthroned on the cherubim. They carried the Ark of God on a new cart and brought it out of the house of Abinadab, which was on the hill. Ezah and Ahio, the sons of Abinadab, were driving the new cart with the Ark of God, and Ahio went in front of the Ark. David and all the house of Israel were dancing before the Lord with all their might, with songs and lyres and harps and tambourines and castanets and cymbals. So David went and brought up the Ark of God from the house of Obed-Edom to the city of David with rejoicing. And when those who bore the Ark of the Lord had gone six paces, he sacrificed an ox and a fatling. David danced before the Lord with all his might. David was girded with a linen of ephod. So David and all the house of Israel brought up the Ark of the Lord with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet. As the Ark of the Lord came into the city of David, Michal, daughter of Saul, looked out of the window and saw King David leaping and dancing before the Lord, and she despised him with her heart. They brought in the Ark of the Lord and set it in its place, inside the tent that David had pitched for it. And David offered burnt offerings and offerings of well-being before the Lord. When David had finished offering the burnt offerings and offerings of well-being, he blessed the people in the name of the Lord of hosts, and distributed food among all the people, the whole multitude of Israel, both men and women. To each a cake of bread, a portion of meat, and a cake of raisins. Then all the people went back to their homes. For the word of God in Scripture, for the word of God among us, for the word of God within us.
Thanks be to God.
Now please join me in reading the Psalm 24, and it may be found in your bulletin. The earth is the Lord's and all that is in it, the world and all who dwell therein. For it is he who founded it upon the seas, and made it firm upon the rivers of the deep. Who can ascend the hill of the Lord, and who can stand in his holy place? Those who have clean hands and a pure heart, who have not pledged themselves to falsehood, nor sworn by what is a fraud. They shall receive a blessing from the Lord and a just reward from the God of their salvation. Such is the generation of those who seek him, of those who seek your face, O God of Jacob. Lift up your heads, O gates. Lift them high, O everlasting doors. And King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O gates. Lift them high, O everlasting doors. And the King of glory shall come in. Who is he, this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Our second reading is from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Paul breaks into a hymn of praise for God's grace in saving a wayward people. Listen now for the word of God. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, just as he chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world to be holy and blameless before him in love. He destined us for his adoption as his children through Jesus Christ, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace that he freely bestowed on us in the beloved. In him, we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace that he lavished on us. With all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure that he set forth in Christ, as a plan for the fullness of time, to gather up all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. In Christ, we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we, who were the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory. In him, you also, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance toward redemption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory. For the word of God in Scripture, for the word of God among us, for the word of God within us.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Mark. King Herod heard of the demons cast out and the many who were anointed and cured for Jesus' name had become known. Some were saying, John the Baptizer has been raised from the dead. And for this reason, these powers are at work in him. But others said, it is Elijah. And others, it is a prophet, like the prophets of old. But when Herod heard of it, he said, John, whom I beheaded, has been raised. For Herod himself had sent men who arrested John, bound him, and put him in prison on account of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife, because Herod had married her. For John had been telling Herod, "It is not lawful for you to have your brother's wife." And Herodias had a grudge against him and wanted to kill him. But she could not, for Herod feared John, knowing that he was a righteous and holy man and protected him. When he heard him, he was greatly perplexed, and yet he liked to listen to him. But an opportunity came when Herod, on his birthday, gave a banquet for his courtiers and officers and for the leaders of Galilee. When his daughter Herodias came in and danced, she pleased Herod and his guests. And the king said to the girl, "Ask me for whatever you wish, and I will give it." And he solemnly swore to her, "Whatever you ask me, I will give you, even half my kingdom." She went out and said to her mother, "What should I ask for?" She replied, "The head of John the Baptizer." Immediately she rushed back to the king and requested, "I want you to give me at once the head of John the Baptist on a platter." The king was deeply grieved. Yet out of regard for his oaths and for the guests, he did not want to refuse her. Immediately, the king sent a soldier of the guard with orders to bring John's head. He went and beheaded him in the prison, brought his head on a platter, and gave it to the girl. Then the girl gave it to her mother. When his disciples heard about it, they came and took his body and laid it in a tomb. The Gospel of the Lord. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. Who are your heroes of the faith? Who are the people who have had an impact on you as you are a Christian? For Jesus, and certainly Mark, John the Baptist was a hero of the faith. We're kind of a strange interlude in this morning's gospel. Last Sunday, Jesus sent out his disciples among the villages to teach and heal. And next Sunday, we will hear the results of this first mission trip. But right in the middle of this sending out of the disciples and their return, Mark drops this story of the death of John the Baptist. So what's going on here? Although this grisly story might seem to be like an interruption in the narrative, it fulfills a definite person in the overall narrative of Mark's gospel. Whereas Luke connects Jesus and John through parallels in their birth stories, Mark connects them by the circumstances of their death. Here, John the Baptist, even in his death, can be seen as foreshadowing Jesus' crucifixion. As I mentioned before, John the Baptist, among other things, was for Jesus and later Mark and the other gospel writers a hero of the faith. When speaking about John to the crowds in both Matthew and Luke, Jesus says, "What did you go out into the wilderness to look at? A reed shaken by the wind? What did you go out to see? someone dressed in soft robes. Look, those who put on fine clothing and live in luxury are in royal palaces. What then did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom it is written, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you who will prepare your way before you." I tell you, among those born of women, no one is greater than John the Baptist. Yet the least in the kingdom of God is greater than he. So I'll ask you once again, who are your heroes of the faith? When I reflect on my life, these are some of the people who come to my mind as heroes of my faith. I think of Mrs. Frail, my third grade Sunday school teacher. She sat in her pew every week with a stack of these red children's prayer books next to her. It's a book of the 1928 service, but slimmed down with just the essential parts for children. This one happened to be given to me by my godparents, but she had a stack of these, and she invited any of us who wanted to sit with her and use our books during the service. My mom never let me. I had to sit with her in the front row. She was nothing special. She was just this little old to us lady. She must have been in her 50s. But she made sure that a bunch of 8-year-olds knew how the service went on Sunday morning and made sure that we participated in it. I still remember her to this day, over 50 years later. Another hero I think of is my high school and college church choir director, Jeff Ricard. He taught me a true appreciation for music and liturgy and how to do it right and well. I think, too, of a summer seminarian during that critical year for me between high school and college, Dean Farrar. Dean helped me to see that not all priests were old men like my father. And he helped to nurture seeds in me that puts me here today. And I think of two priests who were mentors to me as I was starting out. Harry Edwall, for whom I worked in seminary, and who, after he retired, came to hang out with me in Long Beach. And George McLaren, another mentor who helped me as a new rector at a neighboring church down the road, yet who always treated me as an equal and worked together with me on many projects. And I look forward to new heroes of the faith as I continue to grow in my spiritual life and in my life with God. I especially think of Herbert O'Driscoll, who has long been a hero for me and was part of what made my sabbatical so special as I got to know him personally as he led my pilgrimage to Iona. And I think, too, of other new heroes like John Philip Newell, whose writings have formed and informed me in Celtic spirituality. And, of course, the list goes on and on and on. And so I ask you once again, who are your heroes of the faith? Who are the people who helped to mold you? Who shaped you into the person that you are spiritually? It's something good to reflect on. It will take you deep into your life, and it may take you a long way back, even to third grade Sunday school. And then think about who you might be a spiritual hero for. Whose life have you touched in a spiritual way? Who have you helped to know the love of God in their life? Whose life would you like to touch? So I have some homework for you. Homework! It's summer! But nonetheless, here it is. I'd like you to write a spiritual autobiography focusing on the significant people in your life, like I just did. Doesn't have to be in sentences and paragraphs. You can just, you know, bullet points or make a list. Who are those people who made you who and what you are spiritually? Set aside some time and think about it. And then list those people who have made a difference in your life and helped you to be the Christian that they are today. And ponder, too, those whom you might have been a spiritual example for, or perhaps those for whom you want to be a spiritual example. And then, when you have your list, thank God for each person on it, your heroes and others. You might even want to thank them individually, too, if you can, if they're still with us. But hold them up before God and offer a thank you for what they have meant to you. And then look to the future and who or what might be continuing to mold you in your walk with God as you look to be the spiritual person that you might become. Who are your spiritual heroes? Let us pray. God, our Father, you called John the Baptist to be the herald of your Son's birth and death. As he gave his life in witness to truth and justice, so may we strive to profess our faith in your gospel. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And now let us stand as you are able and affirm our faith with the creed in the words of the Iona community. We believe in God above us, maker and sustainer of all life, of sun and moon, of water and earth, of male and female. We believe in God beside us, Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh, born of a woman, servant of the poor, tortured and nailed to a tree. A man of sorrows, he died forsaken. He descended into the earth, to the place of death. On the third day, he rose from the tomb. He ascended into heaven to be everywhere present, and his kingdom will come on earth. We believe in God within us, the Holy Spirit of Pentecostal fire, life-giving breath of the church, spirit of healing and forgiveness, source of resurrection and of eternal life. Amen.
Service continues with the prayers of the people as found in the bulletin. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Your wisdom and insight has made known to us the mystery of your will to gather up all things in Christ. Move with power and justice throughout the earth to unite all people into your divine life. We pray. The earth is God's and all that is in it, the world and all that dwell therein. You choose your church in Christ before the foundation of the world. O gracious one, fill us with such gladness and love of you that we may sing and rejoice in your presence and bless all people in your name. The earth is God's and all that is in it.
The world and all that dwell therein.
Raise up and protect prophets as of old who will challenge the rulers of this age and inspire us to be holy and blameless before you in love. Protect us from political intrigue and from the abuse of power so that our nation may be a people of clean hands and pure hearts. The earth is God's and all that is in it.
The world and all that dwell therein.
In Christ, you have blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. Let your holy presence, strong and mighty, be with all who live in places of injustice or violence. Strengthen all who suffer for the sake of conscience. Protect whistleblowers and those who confront injustice with truth. Visit the prisoners with your mercy and wisdom. The earth is God's and all that is in it.
The world and all that dwell therein.
Give this community wisdom and insight to hear the word of truth and to live in the glorious grace that you freely bestow on us in the Beloved, that your glory may dwell in our land. The earth is God's and all that is in it.
The world and all that dwell therein.
We have set our hope on Christ as we pray for those who are ill or who live with any threat or trauma. The earth is God's and all that is in it.
The world and all that dwell therein.
Let us pray for our needs and those of others. We pray for the church, for our bishops, Justin, Michael, John, and Diane. We pray for St. Columba's, the Threshold Project, our Children's Learning Center, our Project Hope Food Ministries, and our clergy and staff. This morning, we pray for those with immediate needs, Garrett, Kevin, Nancy, Ron, Caitlin, Marlene, Jen, Josette, Melissa, Bruce, Terry, John, Gail, Sylvia, Sarah, Vicky, Kylie, Jerry, Gail, Jackie, Marilyn, Sandy, Maggie, Nazar, Sandy, Denise, Robbie, Rob, Bill, Richard, Dick, Lisa, Savannah, Mona, Val, and Joyce. And we also pray for those who need our continuing prayers, whose names are printed in the bulletin. We give thanks for all members of our St. Columba's Parish family. And we pray for the world, for all who are suffering or have died because of the coronavirus pandemic, for all victims of violence, and we pray to turn the hearts of those who would do harm. We pray for all who have suffered because of the sin of racism and oppression. We pray for those affected by natural disasters, especially wildfires. We pray for peace in the Middle East and all troubled areas of the world. We give thanks for their service, and we pray for all those serving at home and abroad, including Liam, Simon, Matthew, Matt, Nathan, Jonah, David, Noah, Garrett, DeLondon, and Marty. And we give thanks for the flowers on the high altar this morning, which are given to the glory of God by Sarah and Joe Weigert in thanksgiving for all being together again. Please offer your own petitions at this time, either silently or aloud.
For the people of Afghanistan,
we pray for healing for Robin, and thanksgiving for successful surgery for Michael. Hear us as we call upon you, O God, and establish among us your rule of justice and truth, that we may be protected from all evil and live according to the riches of the grace that you have bestowed upon us through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us confess our sins to God. God of all mercy, we confess that we have sinned against you, opposing your will in our lives. We have denied your goodness in each other, in ourselves, and in the world you have created. We repent of the evil that enslaves us, the evil we have done, and the evil done on our behalf. Forgive, restore, and strengthen us through our Savior Jesus Christ, that we may abide in your love and serve only your will. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Would you stand, please, as you are able? The peace of the Lord be always with you. Please greet one another gently in the name of the Lord. And now let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our life and labor unto the Lord as we sing together verses 1, 2, and 4 of Amazing Grace, printed in your bulletin. We continue with the Eucharistic prayer as found printed in your bulletin. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. God of all power, ruler of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise. At your command, all things came to be, the vast expanse of interstellar space, galaxies, suns, the planets and their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home. From the primal elements you brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the rulers of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another. Again and again you called us to return. Through prophets and sages you revealed your righteous law. And in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace. And therefore we praise you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope, to proclaim with them your glory in their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. And so, Father, we who have been redeemed by him and made a new people by water and the Spirit, now bring before you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering now his work of redemption, and offering to you this sacrifice of thanksgiving, we celebrate his death and resurrection as we await the day of his coming. Lord God of our ancestors, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, God of Hannah, Esther, and Ruth, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world about us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only and not for strength, for pardon only and not for renewal. Let the grace of this holy communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name. Risen Lord, be known to us in the breaking of the bread. Accept these prayers and praises, Father, through Jesus Christ, our great high priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, your church gives honor, glory, and worship from generation to generation. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. This is the body of Christ, broken that we may be whole. This cup as promised by God, true to his word, cradles our Lord. Now let us pray with those who could not be with us today the prayer of spiritual communion from the Armed Forces Prayer Book found printed in your bulletin. In union, O Lord, with your faithful people at every altar of your church, where the Holy Eucharist is now being celebrated, I desire to offer to you praise and thanksgiving. I remember your death, Lord Christ. I proclaim your resurrection. I await your coming in glory. And since I cannot receive you today in the sacrament of your body and blood, I beseech you to come spiritually into my heart. Cleanse and strengthen me with your grace, Lord Jesus, and let me never be separated from you. May I live in you and you in me, in this life and in the life to come. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Thank you. post-communion prayer is found printed in your bulletin. Let us pray together. God of abundance, you have fed us with the bread of life and cup of salvation. You have united us with Christ and one another. You have made us one with all your people in heaven and on earth. Now send us forth the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen. And now may the blessing of the God of Abraham and Sarah, and of Jesus Christ, born of our sister Mary, and of the Holy Spirit who broods over creation as a mother over her children, be upon you and remain with you, now and always. Amen. Now let us stand as you are able and sing together our closing hymn, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.